Okay, today I'll be taking the HTML quiz from W3 Schools. You can take it if you want to test your HTML skills or simply because you want to brag to your friends. This test contains 40 questions and there's no time limit, but I'll try to answer the questions as quick as possible. So you get 1 point for each correct answer. I'll try to answer as many correct questions as possible to get the highest score. Now, question number one, what does HTML stand for? Hyperlinks and text, this is not it. Home tool markup, this is not it. Hypertext markup language, now that's the correct answer here. Question two, who is making the web standards? The WWWC is the one who are responsible for developing web standards. The rest are just corporations, so they're incorrect. Question 3. The correct HTML element for the largest heading. HTML headings run from H1 to H6, H1 being the main heading and the largest. The correct element for inserting a line break. BR is the correct one. The other two I've never seen before. Question 5. What is the correct HTML for adding a background color? Option 1 is the correct answer. The rest are just nonsense. We are using inline CSS to change the background here. Question 6. For important text, we use the strong tag. The B and the important and the I are used for something else. Emphasize text, we use the EM tag. For creating a hyperlink, option A, there is no attribute for name in hyperlink, so option A is incorrect. This one is just nonsense. Now this one here, there's no URL attribute, so that one's not correct too, so the last one is the correct one. Which character is used to indicate an ad tag? Well, that is the forward slash. To open a new page, we use the target and we use the attribute name target and the value of underscore blank. That is the correct one, the rest are garbage. Which of these elements are table elements? The first one is incorrect. I've memorized the table and the table is drawn like this. The table tag encloses the entire table. TR is for the table rows and TD is for the table columns. Inline elements are normally displayed without starting a new line. I don't know this, so I'm just going to guess false. How can you make a numbered list? A numbered list is an ordered list, so we use OL, the OL tag. The rest are used for other kinds of lists, except the list tag. Never seen that one. How can you make a bulleted list? A bulleted list is an unordered list, so we use the tag U for unordered list. Just bullet points. What is the correct HTML for making a checkbox? I don't know this one, so I'm just going to guess that. Take the first one, which is input type check. This is a guess. So what is the correct for making a text field? A text field is option number C, which is input type text. For making a drop down list, we use the select tag. And enclosed within it are the options. In order to make a text area, I think we use the text area tag. What is the correct HTML for inserting an image? Now the first one is incorrect, because we don't use the href to indicate the location of the image. And then this one, there's no image tag in HTML. And then this one, I think this one is the correct one. You have the source and you have the alternate text. The correct HTML for inserting a background image. Inline CSS, the first one is the correct one. The rest are incorrect. An iframe is used to display. Yeah, this is true, but it is not recommended because it takes too long to load. A comment, this is true. Block elements are normally displayed without starting a new. I don't know this one, I'm going to guess. I'm going to guess true. Which element defines the title of a document? This one is self-explanatory. The head tag contains information about the website, the meta tag too. Which HTML attribute specifies an alternate text for an image? Long description, source, title, and then alt, that is the one. Which doc type is the correct for HTML5? The first one is incorrect. Options B is the correct one. Which HTML is used to specify the footer? Self-explanatory. The footer. Option C is the correct one here. In HTML, you can embed. This is true. What is the correct HTML element for playing videos? Video. Playing audio. We use audio. The global attribute content editable is, it is used to specify whether content is editable. On blur and focus are event attributes. Graphics defined as SGV are in which element that is extended markup language. The canvas is used to draw graphics. Required is the correct answer here. The slider control, we use range for slider controls. For scalar measurements within a range, we use meter. For the nav bar, we use the nav. Aside is used to denote content that is relevant but not important. It's not the main topics of the website. The header of a document is, this is self-explanatory header. The last one is the one that is correct. Now for the results. I got 92. I missed 2 questions. But this year I can be proud of myself, you know. It's time to check which answers I got incorrect. So I got incorrect, correct, correct, incorrect. Okay, madaman. Madaman. Oh, this one, question 12. It's supposed to be true. I thought it was a guess. Oh man, I don't know how I missed that. Checkbox. And this one, question 23, block elements are normally displayed without starting a new line. That is supposed to be true. It's time to brag anyways. It's time to post on Facebook. It's time to brag about my score. You know, the only thing you get from completing this test are bragging rights. So you might as well try to brag too.